Hey guys, so I'm probably late in talking about this, but this is something that was kind of brought to my attention when I was coming here from Tennessee. I was on the bus ride. It's a 17-hour bus ride from Tennessee to New York. And when I was on the bus, I was looking at my phone at one point and going through my Twitter feed. And that's when I became aware of all these fast food workers planning to strike across the country and demand and protest, demand that they be paid $15 an hour at least. So that was kind of the story that I became aware of. At this point, I think they already did the strike. So I think this is old news, but it's still such a interesting topic for me. My gut reaction when I read this was like, wow, this is amazing. This is inspiring at least. Like that's kind of the feeling that I had. Like I was inspired. I know not a lot of people may have felt that way when they were reading this, but I was inspired for one really huge reason why I felt that way was because, well, fast food workers, they're not union workers. There are no unions for fast food workers. Same thing with waiters and waitresses and such. They're non-union workers. They could be fired anytime. A lot of them, the companies that employ them, try to always find these crazy loophole ways to pay them lower than minimum wage or whatever, or they have no benefits, no vacation time or any kind whatsoever. So that's kind of the thing with fast food workers. So how do these workers, non-union workers, organize themselves to do humongous strikes and protests across the country and across companies? This isn't just McDonald's workers doing strikes. This isn't just Burger King workers doing strikes or In-N-Out workers doing strikes. This is, or Taco Bell workers doing strikes. This is like all of them doing strikes across the entire country. Like, how is this possible? Well, one big huge component was unions in other service industries. Retail, I think retail unions were the big ones, like unions from JCPenney. I think JCPenney was one. I have no idea. All I know is like other areas, other workers' unions really helped, and their leadership came in. And and automobile unions, I think. I don't know. I don't remember the exact details, but unions really assisted in organizing this team and doing the strike and demanding, $15 an hour. I think that's kind of giving the shock value, because when we think of fast food workers, they're minimum wage jobs. Most of them make $7.25, $7.75. I think that's the average amount they make. Some make even less, depending on the state and depending on what kind of company has found a loophole to pay them less. So it's just like $15 an hour. And I've been reading, some kind of Facebook comments or Twitter reactions to that. Of course, many people's reactions is like, that's ridiculous. Come on, like McDonald's workers, it's a non-skill job. You don't need a high school degree to even have that job. And you're a fry cook getting paid $15 an hour is a ridiculous idea. They don't deserve that amount because anybody could do it, right? That's a lot of the reactions I saw from people. And I can kind of, I don't know. I don't want to say I understand the sentiment, but I guess that's the sentiment that they have. I guess that's, I couldn't. I can see that's a lot of the reactions that people have. I'm clearly not, on that side. That's not my line of thinking, but it was a lot of line thinking for a lot of the people. And I think the shock value of unskilled workers having $15, I think as part of it is because there's many other fields that is actually much requires more skill, requires more training, and knowledge base and experience, and those areas, they don't get $15 an hour. Many areas are like that. When I was a in my example, in some nonprofit agencies in New York City, which tends to pay higher than many other places around the country, you could be a supervisor in a nonprofit organization and you'd be making $14, $13 an hour. They don't make $15 an hour. So compared to that, it's just like, what? Fast food workers getting 15? That's ridiculous. That's crazy. And also because there's also this notion that a lot of the people who work in fast food restaurants are high school students or college students. So they only have this job to just work there for a while, and they'll move on, graduate from college, and they'll get better jobs. So these are temporary transitional jobs. A lot of people have that kind of mindset, except it's not really the reality of things. That's the problem, I think. And I think a lot of people kind of don't realize that many fast food workers, that's their job. It's not temporary jobs, that's their jobs. And many people use that job to support themselves and to support families, to support their children and their spouses and their cousins and whatnot. To support themselves, that's their job, not just a temporary high school student job. And, I think we, at least in America, we have this notion of the American work ethic. You have to work hard in order to succeed. You know, you wake up in the morning, you work hard as you can, and then you work, and then you go home, and then you sleep early, you wake up early in the morning, and then you work, and you work at least 5 days a week, or even 6 days a week, and you just work, and that way you pull yourself with your bootstrap, and you succeed, and you achieve the American dream. It's why in the developing world, compared to many other, you know, industrialized or developed nations, America has the least like amount of paid vacation time and all that kind of stuff. And that kind of mindset is one of the big reasons why. And I could really see that mindset just be totally reflected on people's reactions to the story. And honestly, I'm not really concerned with the question, do McDonald's workers deserve $15 an hour? It's kind of like, I'm not really interested in answering that question. What does concern me is that they deserve more right now than what they're getting right now. And my basis for that kind of response is because, well, a lot of people who work in fast food restaurants, that's not their only job. We are expecting people to have two or three jobs to support themselves. What kind of system is that? What kind of expectation is that? Especially when their bosses' bosses, you know, especially when the people who are managing this operations have incomes that would pretty much feed thousands of employees. One person is getting the income of like 10,000 people. Okay, maybe that's an exaggeration. Getting the income of like, I don't know, 5,000 people. Maybe that's an exaggeration. Getting the income of 1,000 people. I don't know. But, you know, the higher people, this income disparity is kind of ridiculous, and it doesn't need to be that extreme in order for a company to be extremely profitable. That's the point. The point of a business is to be profitable. I totally understand that. But the question is, at what cost? If the cost is at the expectation that the worker has to work two or three jobs, or that the worker has to get food stamps in addition to their income in order to provide for themselves and for their family, holy crap, what kind of twisted and sick and mean expectation is that, is my point. And current minimum wage hasn't accounted for inflation in so many years. So, you know, minimum wage probably should be increased, but that's minimum wage is always forcing companies to pay whatever, you know. But my hope, my biggest hope from this whole story, and I'll end it with this, my hope is that eventually, and this is probably just me being naive and being idealistic, but my hope is that companies realize you pay your workers the amount that makes them happy, makes them at least comfortable and be in a productive state. You'll get profits, and you'll have good business, you'll have good reputation. And, you know, I think a company like In-N-Out is probably a good example. They don't pay their workers $15 an hour, but, you know, they get like $10.25 an hour or something like that, and they train their workers well. The good thing about paying workers well, is even for an unskilled job like a fry cook, the good thing about it, in my opinion, is that it keeps workers. There's less likelihood of a worker quitting or being fired, because if you think about it, if a worker is coming to your workplace after having worked a different job or a second shift at a different job because they need two or three jobs in order to, you know, maintain themselves. Then they come to work tired, groggy, just in a horrible work state. They're more likely to get sick. And when they do get sick, they're more likely to get fired or quit. And you need to replace your worker. And the amount of money that goes into training another worker, the retention rate of workers is really important to the bottom line, to profits. So that's also something to consider. And as us consumers are becoming more and more aware of these kind of workplace issues, there's also a reputation issue. I think there was a news article about this fast food restaurant that is giving its workers $12 an hour. Yeah, that's pretty hot. And the article was on how the owner of that restaurant, that burger place, I think, I've got the name of it, is actually planning to raise their wages to $15 an hour. That's the plan of that fast food place. And he actually said, like, that's, you know, that brought awareness to the community. And a lot of people come to that restaurant knowing their employees are treated like human beings and not like factory machines. And that's one of the things that I feel when I go into these kind of fast food places, or I don't really go to fast food places, but sometimes I do go into kind of like places where you order food and pick them up. Like there's a lot of pizza places in your city. Sometimes I get spaghetti and falafel places, and just seeing them work, like I can't imagine myself being in that situation where for 8 hours straight I have to be doing this same remote, like redundant, repetitive action of putting in food, taking out, taking orders. Like, I've done that before in high school, actually. But, like, imagining that as a job, like, it's non-skilled work, sure, but it's certainly not easy work, you know? And they're treated like factory machines. But they're not factory machines. They're human beings. And I think that's the crux of the point that I think should be raised to many employers and companies that employ these people. But that's my two cents. I don't know. Probably gonna have a lot of disagreements with a lot of people. But yeah, feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section below. And just, you know, whatever you want to discuss is fine. But those are my two thoughts, two cents on the whole issue. All right? Cheers.